Welcome to Merton Chapel for this service of Choral Evensong. Today the church celebrates the feast of the early Christian martyr, St. Clement of Rome. Information about the music in tonight's service can be found on page 6 of your service booklets. The choir now sings Psalm 121, which can be found in the Book of Common Prayer. We sit for the psalmody.
The first lesson is written in the prophecy of Jeremiah, chapter 31. At that time, says the Lord, I will be the God of all the families of Israel, and they shall be my people. Thus says the Lord, the people who survived the sword found grace in the wilderness when Israel sought for rest. The Lord appeared to him from far away. I have loved you with an everlasting love, therefore I have continued my faithfulness to you. Again I will build you, and you shall be built, O virgin Israel. Again you shall take your tambourines and go forth in the dance of the merrymakers. Again you shall plant vineyards on the mountains of Samaria, and the planters shall plant and shall enjoy the fruit. For there shall be a day when sentinels will call in the hill country of Ephraim. Come, let us go up to Zion, to the Lord our God. For thus says the Lord, sing aloud with gladness for Jacob, and raise shouts for the chief of the nations. Proclaim, give praise, and say, save, O Lord, your people, the remnant of Israel. See, I am going to bring them from the land of the north and gather them from the farthest parts of the earth, among them the blind and the lame, those with child and those in labor together, a great company. They shall return here. With weeping they shall come, and with consolations I will lead them back. I will let them walk by brooks of water in a straight path in which they shall not stumble. For I have become a father to Israel, and Ephraim is my firstborn. Here ends the first lesson.
Thank you. The second lesson is written in the Gospel according to Matthew, chapter 15. Jesus left that place and went away to the district of Tyre and Sidon. Just then, a Canaanite woman from that region came out and started shouting, "Have mercy on me, Lord, Son of David. My daughter is tormented by a demon." But he did not answer her at all. And his disciples came and urged him, saying, "Send her away, for she keeps shouting after us." He answered, "I was sent only to the lost sheep of the house of Israel." But she came and knelt before him, saying, "Lord, help me." He answered, "It is not fair to take the children's food and throw it to the dogs." She said, "Yes, Lord, yet even the dogs eat the crumbs that fall from their master's table." Then Jesus answered her, "Woman, great is your faith. Let it be done for you as you wish." And her daughter was healed instantly. After Jesus had left that place, he passed along the Sea of Galilee, and he went up the mountain where he sat down. Great crowds came to him, bringing with them the lame, the maimed, the blind, the mute, and many others. They put them at his feet, and he cured them. So that the crowd was amazed when they saw the mute speaking, the maimed whole, the lame walking, and the blind seeing. And they praised the God of Israel. Here ends the second lesson.
Today's anthem is Oh That I Once Past Changing Were, with words by George Herbert and music by Lennox Barclay.
Let us pray. The prophet speaks, the people who survived the sword found grace in the wilderness. As we give thanks for Saint Clement and all the martyrs who have borne witness to God's grace in the midst of persecution, so let us pray tonight for all who seek grace in the wilderness. For everyone seeking peace and community in the midst of conflict, for all seeking healing of body, mind, or soul in the midst of illness, for all seeking shelter in the midst of homelessness, friendship in isolation, freedom in addiction. And may the wild places of the earth tonight flourish in the grace of our common Creator. Creator and Father of eternity, whose martyr Clement bore witness with his blood to the love he proclaimed and the gospel that he preached, give us thankful hearts as we celebrate your faithfulness revealed to us in the lives of your saints, and strengthen us in our pilgrimage as we follow your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Jesus went up the mountain, where he sat down and cured the sick. In this, the final week of the Christian year, we hear how Jesus sits to offer healing from a place of rest. So let us pause to receive God's blessings at this turning of the season. Let us give thanks for the good things we have received this year, and let us pass into God's hands for safekeeping anything we have left unfinished or undone, and for healing those things which have troubled us as we look with hope towards the year to come. God of endings and beginnings, God of time and change and pause, we give you thanks that all which has been, is, and is to come unfolds within the horizon of your love. And we long for the day when the turning of the seasons will come to rest in your eternal peace, through Jesus Christ, who is our peace.
Amen.
So in the silence of this holy place, we offer before God now the prayers on our own hearts. And we gather together all of our prayers in the words of the grace. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen. We stand now to sing our office hymn, number 219.